Happy Friday evening. So tonight I'm going to do I bought a just a bush of cauliflower. And I want to try a recipe that I've seen, and it looked really super good. So this is the first time I'm going to be doing this. So just kind of take off the leaves, the rotted ones, kind of look around or whatever. This is like, I wanted a bigger one. Look how small that is. It's just like a little teeny tiny one. So we're gonna bake this baby. So first, I just want to get all this stuff off, get this washed. I'm not gonna eat that anyways, so I don't care if it's on there. All right, so we're gonna get this washed up. And oh, I lost my paper towels. What the heck did I do with my paper towels? Hold on. Right, so we're just gonna blot this dry. And then we're gonna set it aside. We're going to take some parchment paper. Last time when I did parchment paper, I forgot what I was cooking in here. But it wouldn't stay. Oh, I know what it was. It was my egg roll up that I did. And it didn't stay, and this one's definitely not staying either. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of oil, just a teeny tad, and just place it on the bottom and just kind of rub it like so the parchment paper stays on there. It says to put parchment paper on it. I certainly don't want my broccoli sticking to the, or my cauliflower sticking to the bottom of the pan. So I like using parchment paper for a lot of stuff, including my art projects. If you guys haven't jumped over, hop on to my The Wannabe Artist on my YouTube channel, guys. Wannabe Artist exclamation point. I have a few videos. I put my cooking videos on there too, as well. It's just under cooking. Ah! Cooking videos. What the frig? What the fork? What the fork? Ugh. Okay. I think I put too much oil in there. I don't need that much. Oh. Okay. So then we're going to place the parchment paper. See? It sticks. That's my way, guys. I don't know about you guys, but that's my thingy. All right. So we're going to place this aside. And what we're going to do now is we're just going to take some butter. I'm just getting my hands are clean. I'm just going to take my hand and just kind of rub it on like so. Just rub it all over the cauliflower. I like cauliflower. A lot of people don't like it, but I'm going to bake this. So, I mean, this is just the right size for me because it's just me. Right, and get it all nice and coated with butter. Got that going on. And then we're gonna season it up just a little bit before I apply the mustard in the mustard mixture. I'm gonna season it up with this. I like it. I can't pronounce it, but it's delicious. It's every seasoning you want. Onion, mushrooms, all kinds of stuff. Yeah, so I like it. And it's new. I mean, I've never seen this before. I found it at Aldi's. I'm an Aldi's person too. I love Aldi's. And so we're just gonna put it all around there like that. Ooh, looks delicious already. Oh yeah. Okay. And then we're gonna place this in over here in the pan for a second. We're gonna take our mustard, get our mustard up. Mix that baby up. Don't need a whole lot, like I said, because it's only that little small little thingy. I'm gonna put a little bit of coconut oil in. Very, very little. Just like drop. Oh my God, that wasn't a drop. That definitely was not a damn drop. My spoon dropped in the sink. Urgh. Okay. So we're going to mix this in. Oh, I love mustard. I don't know about you guys. I like mustard on almost everything besides my meat. But other than that, like, I can dip my potato chips in it. Whole bunch of stuff. I just love it. I'm going to put some more of this in here as well. Sorry, this video is going to go on a little bit late, guys. I was, like, kind of watching movies, and then I was talking to my son, and he got a new job, and I'm so proud of him. Me next. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we're just going to spread the mustard just on top of here, like this. I don't want too much on here. And then we're going to put it in the oven for 25 minutes. We're going to let this baby bake in the oven, 350, 25 minutes. Okay? All right, that's good. I don't want too much mustard. I made too much. That's okay. I'll use it for my bologna and lettuce sandwiches. All right. Excuse me. We're going to pop this in, 350, 25 minutes. All right, and then I will be back. Okay, so here it is. It actually, it's been like 35 minutes. I wanted the cauliflower to get kind of soft. So there it is. It looks delicious. Guys, it smells so freaking good. You don't even know. I've never baked cauliflower in my entire life. Okay, so what we're going to do now is I'm going to get dirty another dish that I hate to wash. And going to do, I'm going to sprinkle a little bit more of this seasoning on here. And now we're going to take, oh my God, you guys. Oh, it smells so damn good. I'm just going to put a little bit more butter on here. Just a little bit. And actually, I'm going to slice it a little bit. Before I put the cheese on, because I want the cheese to maybe go in the middle a little bit. I don't know. I'm just experimenting, guys. I don't know. At least all this is sure is cooking up. I'm just gonna slice it. Okay, it's getting tender. It's getting tender. Oh, guys. Excuse me. So I'm watching Shrek. I haven't watched Shrek in a while. Oh my God. You guys, that tastes delicious. Like with the mustard, you would not even think, like, the mustard and everything combined. By the way, I looked up the other recipe, and it's olive oil, you guys. Olive oil mixed with Dijon mustard. But whatever, like, this that I mixed with the coconut oil and the mustard, it tastes awesome. Okay. Oh, my God, I'm dropping everything. So now we're going to put... I'm putting mozzarella cheese. You can put whatever cheese you want on top. Now it's like only to get it. Oh, I got a leaf in there. Okay, let's see. How are you going to do this? I'm going to take like 5 minutes just trying to figure out how to stand it up. Dang it. Oh, that irks me. That irks me. But anyways, okay. So you put this on and then you put it in for another. I'm hoping the cheese sticks in there really good. Let me press it down. Just like a G-hole. Look, it's sticking. It's not going nowhere now. I got the butter in there. So we're good. A little bit more. Sorry, this video is going to be late, you guys, because it's taking a little bit, and then I have to upload the video, and add it to the group and also to my the wannabe artist YouTube channel. So okay, so I'm gonna let it go right here. I'm gonna put this baby back in the oven for let's say 20 minutes again, and then I will be back. Okay, hey, I'm back. So what I'm gonna do is the cauliflower is still in the oven. It's done. I just wanted to show you I'm going to mix up some cheese and just a teaspoon of butter. And with this, I'm gonna put it in the microwave and just melt it to dip the cauliflower in. Oh. Okay, only put that on like a good 30 seconds or whatever. Alright, so now I'm going to grab. Where's my other mitt? Here it is. And I'm gonna grab the. Get this out of the oven. I haven't even seen it yet, I guess. I put the foil over the last 15 minutes of it. I did like slice through it a little bit in between a little bit of break and put some cheese in the middle, and hopefully that made it a little bit better. Okay, so let's go. Let's get this butter out of the way. Hello, Barbara. Okay. Got that melted cheese and butter. Oh my God, you guys, it smells so freaking good. Okay. So let's remove the foil. Ooh, yes, honey bun. Yes. Ooh, ooh, ooh. So, okay. So really quick. Look at that. Oh my God, you guys. So I did slice it in and I stuffed the cheese in there. Because I love my cheese in cauliflower or broccoli or whatever. So yes. Yes, 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 yes. I'm going to, oh, I love this parchment paper. I just love it. Like you can do any, literally anything on it. Arts, whatever. Okay. So, we'll remove my gloves. Whoops. 1 second. Okay, sorry. I just want to make sure we're on. So, going to look at. Guys, it smells so freaking good. Like, I'm not, like. And the broccoli is nice and soft. I just want to cut a little bit here. Hopefully I can get like, I got like this. Oh my God, this like came right off. Oh, okay. All right. So, ow, 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 ow. Oh, you guys, look. Oh my God. Yes. I'm going to taste it. I'm not going to show you me eating it, but whatever. I'm going to put a little bit on here. And I need a fork, another fork that I don't want to wash. Ugh. Oh. You guys. Oh my God. Oh my freaking God. Do this for like, I don't know, like a side dish or something like that. Look at the cheese. Mmm. Mmm. Alright. So there you go, you guys. Gorgeous. I'm gonna take a picture and add it to the post. And I'm sorry it's so late. It took like, I'm telling you guys, it took an hour. It took an hour and 10 minutes to do everything because it's just baking. So you have to give the cauliflower a little bit of time to cook in the middle. So you just put a lot of stuff on. You put the mustard, the olive oil, whatever you want to use. But I'm telling you, the mustard is really good with it. Really good. And just like the cheese and the butter and everything. Oh my God. So good. I love you guys. Have an awesome night. Peace.